Hi, I'm Robin Ménage. Today we will talk about sport and fasting because this might surprise you, but you can go without food for a few days, even weeks, burning your fat and still do some sport. So we will talk about that with Alexandra, who is our personal trainer at the clinic. And so we will explain in detail what you can do at home and why sport is actually beneficial during fasting. So Alex, can you tell us about your experience at the clinic and how you are managing the patients?
Yes, for sure. So our clients often tell us they were able to reduce or even to stop taking antihypertensive drugs or insulin after consultation with the doctor, of course. Their joint pain grew less or disappeared completely, and also their tension in their body released sometimes also completely. They felt generally fitter and more resilient, and also their body awareness improved.
That's really fantastic. And there's always a legend that we are losing muscles during fasting and that can be dangerous. And we even did some studies on the topic. And we published last year a study where some patients at the clinic, they were doing the fasting program and a lot of exercise. And we followed them during the fast and after they finished the fast as well. And we clearly thought that there would be no problem, and this was confirmed because the patients were really fully energetic and they really didn't lose proteins. At least the muscles really didn't lose function, because when we measured the performance of the muscle, it was even better after fasting. And now we are doing even this new study called Genesis, where we looked by MRI if the composition of the muscle is changing, and we look at the whole body to know what are the changes. Is there anything, in your opinion, that the patient should not do?
Yeah, the patient should avoid intensive or high maximum intensity during fasting, especially during the first 3 days when the metabolism has to adapt. They have to be careful. And of course, if they feel dizzy or shaky or unwell during their training, they have to stop immediately and make sure that they drink enough.
Okay, and so what are their most frequent questions? Because I feel that this can also interest our viewers.
Yeah, of course. So our patients, our guests often ask us if it's possible to train during fasting, and if it's possible, how to train, and also if they will lose musculature during fasting.
And is there some exercise like weight trainings which are impossible during fasting, or you propose really a range and personalize as the patient is fit for?
So it's possible to do strength training, for example, weight training, but it's also a question in which personal performance you are, in which state of mental health or physical health you are. And so it's also a question if you start, restart, or if you would like to continue your training. So test your own limits carefully, especially during the first 3 days. And if you feel well, of course, you can increase the level or the intensity, but carefully.
And there's many patients who come because they want to lose weight, and we often say that it's not like the primary aim of fasting. Sometimes we even say that it's like a beneficial side effect, and that the effects of fasting are really multiple and others for prevention. What do you think about this topic of losing weight and sport? Is it something that people ask a lot, and what do you think about it?
Yeah, for the guests are very important to lose much weight, but the most important thing is to save your skeletal system. And so, of course, if patients are fasting or guests are fasting and they don't exercise, they will lose more weight instead of people who exercise regularly. But this is not a benefit of your skeletal system. And so it's a must to exercise because we want to save the protein in our muscles.
Yeah, that's actually also the case in many animals, because humans are probably the only animal which doesn't fast regularly. And many animals are also doing some physical exercise, like migratory birds or whales, like all these animals which are traveling across the planet. Sometimes they are fasting and their muscles are preserved. And it's because we have these mechanisms in our muscles that are called protein sparing. And when we activate it with exercise, our muscles are preserved and the proteins, they are coming from somewhere else, like from intestine or liver, which are regenerated by this autophagy during fasting. So we are really programmed to do some exercise during fasting. And I'm glad to hear that this is also something you can observe clinically with the patients.
Yeah, it's like a natural break for your body, or your body has a natural break. So if you use your muscles, your body knows not to attack the protein.
Yeah, this is really something which is natural. And for the patients who come back after fasting at home, I guess they have learned a lot during their stay at the clinic, and maybe they want to have something easy that they can do at home. Also for the customers doing the fasting box, because it's also an intervention where some physical exercise is good. So do you have some recommendations that people can do at home easily if you don't have so much time? Let's imagine this, like the businessman who have no much time because of a very intense life. What type of exercise would you recommend?
Yes, of course. So test yourself the first 3 days, because your metabolism has to adapt, and do some gentle things which feels good for you. For example, some yoga exercises, stretching, easy Pilates. We also develop many movements during the first lockdown, so maybe you can have a look at these movies in the application. And after the first 3 days, so from the fourth day, usually the people feel more fit, they are in a better mood, they have more energy. And so you can start with strength training in your gym or at home. You can do some exercises for legs, for arms, stability, core training, just 10 to 15 minutes, or in combination with walking, easy running sessions, or an easy hike if it's possible the next day after. But rest in between, this is very important, especially after strength training, because your body needs time to rebuild all energies in your body, to refill all energy reserves, and to repair all these processes, especially in your muscles.
Yeah, that's a very good point. And we are really interested also at what happens after fasting from the science point of view, because in our last study, we saw that when the food was reintroduced, the synthesis of protein in the muscle was boosted. And so we can expect that if there is anything lost during fasting, this will be recovered straight after. And this is a natural mechanism. We are really adapted for this, like animals which are fasting every year according to seasons. We have even these patients who come every year and they don't get weak in the end. They're still really fit. I remember this patient who came for 96 times to the clinic, and he's 93 years old. And last time I met him, he gave me a handshake, and I can tell you that he's not weak.
Of course, yeah. So fasting is like cleansing for your body and for your mind. So it's also necessary, or it's good to do activity and also relaxation during fasting. It's like a reset for your body. And so don't stress yourself during fasting.
Well, thank you for this advice. It's really insightful and quite practical. So thank you for sharing this experience during this video. And thank you for watching this video. And if you want to have more information about fasting and what you can do during your stay or what you can do at home, feel free to subscribe to our channel and follow our videos. So thank you for watching.